And let me tell you how I never changed. I never switched up. Always been this thirsty. Look, I always had the hiccups. Now it's
touchdown Nigeria. And I have to do the mandatory. You know, I have to let my people know I'm really in the country. I'm here. I'm home.
Up with the weights, I work. Down with the pack, I roll.
That's the shit.
How you doing?
Brother, welcome to Lagos, brother. Well, good to have you, man.
Yo, what's up? What's up, man? This is the Jiggy Jigger, the coolest kid in Africa, Nasty C. Right now, you tune in to Beat FM. Don't change that down. Gidi.
Hey, guys. Nasty C is in the building. Make sure you tune into the Beats 99.9 FM. How's your flight? You flew in literally today, right?
Yeah. Just landed like an hour ago.
Just landed an hour ago. And of course, rest. You came straight here. Because we love you.
Yeah, I had to. Papa sent me a text and told me I'm heaven sent. I never became a doctor, but made me some M&Ms. They tried to keep me on the other side of the fence, and now my niggas living on the other side of the lens. We made it and made it possible. And now it's bullseye, bro. Hey, I made my people proud to be in global.
What do you think about the Nigerian audience in comparison to the South African audience?
I think it's crazy because up here, obviously, the numbers are way larger than ours in SA, like in terms of the population. One. Two, you guys can afford data way better than we can in SA. So you guys are online the whole time. You guys know the lyrics.
You'll understand the shit when you can get to fly solo and crack your brain trying to figure out if you want the door suicide or normal. That's suicide without a pill or rope.
Everybody can rhyme and vibe to your music. I mean, how does that feel to you?
I wouldn't lie, bro. For me, in the beginning, it was kind of like that too, because I didn't think my music would spread that rapidly like that. So I wasn't expecting it at first.
First of all, I have to say, like, I think you're super talented. For us in Nigeria, when it really became like, this guy is a beast, is when you did the Coke Studio. Thing is, I don't even watch it, but then I saw it on YouTube and I was like, oh, let me see what he's going to do. It's nice to see. And then you absolutely destroyed that song.
Thank you.
What was that? Was it? Had you wrote it before, or it was a freestyle? It was a freestyle.
We wrote our verses, the whole song, on camera. One,
two. Oh my Jesus!
You telling me not even just a little bit? 24 karat, you made me rich. 24 karat, I hit a lick. You left in my joke 3 times in a row. I pray for your LOL. You sent it LMAO.
But how do you get to pull off all this at your age? I mean, not everybody thinks like and gets to the stage. Yeah. I think you're actually one of the youngest in South Africa. Yeah. I mean, even in Africa, actually. So, I mean, how do you pull that off? Because it's not easy. The fame, the women.
Yeah, right.
I mean, how do you put that together?
With regards to the skill and the talent side of it, I guess it's just because I started when I was very young. So I guess now it's like...
How young, actually?
I was 9.
9.
First time I made a beat, I was 9. It was whack. But I was 9. Since then, I've just been doing it consistently. Every time I got home, just did the same thing.
Dude, I'm out here looking like I tripped and fell in gold. Dude, my album sounded like it tripped and fell in gold. These women going platinum, how they out here selling souls. These women going platinum, how they out here selling coochie. I was a diamond in the rough, and then the right hands took me.
But generally, do you prefer Nigerian girls or South African girls?
Hey, man. All women are beautiful. I don't know. You're trying to set me up. I'm not going to fall for you.
I just want to know your preference. So I know if I have a chance when I shoot my shot.
The right hands found me. Success is like a song on replay every day. I like how that shit sounded. Man, damn it, man. I think that shit's a smash. Hey, I jammed to that shit until I pass. So, mom, I'm happy that you let my daddy smash. You know, that's my nigga. I will never leave him ass out. Strings and blings.
Strings and blings. Why strings and blings?
Guitars, connections, referring to the strings part. Bling, just being young, being him, and joy.
Anyways, thank you for coming on the
thank
show,
you.
Casper. Keep working hard. Yes. We love you in Nigeria.
Me o fe mo gba ninja, eh. I pray to God, say I go make her, eh. She dey feel the bass when they make the girl shake her, eh. If you fuck around, you go make my guys ginger. I be making a lot in the yo, man. I be balling the yo. Never be saving the yo. I be uploading the yo, getting the yo. Man, I go take your yo.
So we gotta go get some rest. Because we got more wins tomorrow. One thing you always have to do, even when people call you a master at what you do, is go back to the drawing board. Make sure all your plans are straight, you know. So I'm about to go back to my drawing board at my home in Nigeria, Universal Studios.
Collaborations, like we've always said, is nothing is forced. Everything is, if it works, if it blends, we work. That's how it is. And that's the way it should be. It's organic, it's authentic. The story always has to be authentic.
When I land in Nigeria, there's just a couple people I have to see. People I have to get with, connect with, and make music with.
I call Runtown, Sprinttown. Me and him run up, drip down. I did what you could and you pissed now. I turn a diamond with Chris Brown. Yeah.
Shit.
We gotta finish this.
And of course, one of those people is my brother Runtown.
I call Runtown, Sprinttown. Me and him run up, drip down. I did what you could and you pissed now. I tell a diamond go Chris Brown. Yeah, pull it on your hair, I'm psyched. Then I tell you, drop it like Link in a bike. I dig you like I'm trying to find gold. You scratch my back like
I'm trying to type.
Ski, 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 ski.
You're going down the chord, yeah, right there.
You guys love the sound. You guys love it. You guys know it. Why are y'all pretending? So now it's time to shove it down their throats, bro. Like, we have Particular. Particular is like a banger out here. Said is the biggest. Like, that song I hear on radio every day. Like, bro, they can play like now and next 15 minutes, they're playing it again on the same station.
Yeah.
Coca-Cola is going in on that shit. Like, it's not like, oh, who's on this? Whose song is this? The name is Runtown and Nasty, yeah, for sure. Yeah. That's the biggest Coke studio song.
Yeah.
So me and Runtown just recorded two bangers, and it was all just effortless. And you know why that happens? It's because me and him understand what the people want and need from us, and we give it to them, and we do it. And we do it right every single time, you dig?
I remember say it wasn't easy. Right now and everything is amazing.
So tonight I'm back in studio. We're going to set it up anywhere we can. Get a couple sessions in and do the most we can. First off, my boy VEC.
Because he has hip hop songs.
That's cool. This is vibe too.
Yeah, that's why I asked him. Because, I mean, it's whatever is art, right? So if we get this done ASAP, I'll play you something else you like.
Barbie.
Undo.
What's that? Stella McCartney.
Undo.
Dance for me now. Dance for me now.
Basham.
Dance for me now. Dance for me now.
Basham. Kenny, yeah.
Let's do it back. All the way back to the 70s. Ooh. Did you die, go to heaven, came back, gave him hell again and again?
Again and again. You know, when I stay proud to rack it. Anytime when I buzz for the banging, I was really done with the fuck boys part of my life, thus the abandon. So see the smile is the new way, ladies love VEC like it's Cool J.
And then I said I'll go from there. We just fucking
right. Why are you even?
What's that? A new Barbie? What's that? Stella McCartney? Dance for me now, dance for me now. She can break it right back in and out.
Can somebody call this guy studio tape? Let's go. We get real busy, long days. You just log in and tweet long threads.
Oh, you probably stepped the whole shit. You took
it. Man, we're burnt out. We've been working all day.
My daughter.
Going hard. It's been a very productive day. As you can see, everybody looks tired. Everybody looks drained. So we gotta go get some rest.
Nigeria is fucking epic. This has been my best trip to Niger in the history of my life and my career.
Yeah,
this time I felt welcome. I got to join the culture. I ate the food. I got to mingle with the people. Studio with some artists. It's just been crazy.
This is my journey.